everybody. Welcome back to My View on the View, the podcast where I make the view table relatable. Well, guys, there's a conversation that's been happening online with some fans of The View. I would say, as a vlogger, I started noticing it probably in late October. It may have been taking place way before then, so I'm just going to say October because that's when I first noticed it. And that is that a lot of people are suspecting that there is some beef going between Sara Haines and Sonny Hostin. In October, when they were beginning to discuss various topics, it did seem like Sonny and Sara were on the opposite ends of the topics. They just didn't agree. But remember, Megan wasn't there. This was the panel of grown women, grown ass women, as I like to say, because Anna was there. And they would very often disagree agreeably, which is very difficult to do. Well, in November, right after voting day, the next day the show came on, and of course, the results of the election were still slowly but surely coming in. And of course, you know, we found out that so many millions of people voted for Trump, which was baffling to a lot of people. And a lot of people were on different sides of the fence when it came to why did so many people vote for him? Why was the race so close? And so that's where we're going to pick up with the clip. So they were having that discussion. The panel consisted that day of Whoopi, Joy, Anna, Sara, and Sonny. So go with me as we listen to this piece, and then I'll be back and I'll tell you the rest of the story.
I mean, for the past 4 years, this president has shown us that he is a misogynist, that he is homophobic, that he is racist, and that he mismanaged a coronavirus pandemic to the tune of over 250,000 American deaths. Yet 50% of America saw all of that and looked the other way to their brothers and their sisters and said, I'm going to vote for him anyway. And that is really disheartening because for me, that means that you are selfish, right? I'm not going to say that 50% of Americans are racist and sexist and homophobic, but I will say that that tells me that they will look the other way to that kind of behavior, to the plight of their fellow Americans, if personally they feel that they are doing okay and that they will do better under that type of presidency. And that, I think, is despicable. It is un-American.
Actually disagree with Sonny when she... I felt a disheartening feeling when I looked at the map because of how red it was, but I think to automatically assume that half of the country is selfish, voting is a selfish thing. That's why we always say, you know, we oftentimes assign people to groups. Like, if you're a woman, you should vote for Hillary Clinton. If you're black, we all vote one way. If you're Hispanic, we don't. We vote for what affects our day-to-day lives. And Van Jones said back in 2016, when he went around the country, he talked about being with white voters that had voted for President Obama that were now voting for Trump. And he said he looked at them with a new set of eyes. They were voting on the economy because they couldn't put food on their table. And whether I agree with the economy being the reason to vote for Trump or not, that's their choice. That's their vote. And they're just as American as we are. They have a different viewpoint. That was the part that really shocked me on election night is how different it was.
The problem, Sarah, though, is that our very democracy is founded on the notion of a collective spirit. We the people. Right? We the people, for the people, by the people. And unless you have that collective social contract, our democracy fails. So when you see 50% of the country just looking the other way at the plight of 50% or more of the country, at the plight of the LGBTQ community, at the plight of African Americans, at the plight of immigrants, their children are being torn from them at the border, at the plight of people that are losing their spouses, their children, their brothers, their sisters from a deadly virus because this president could not control it because he lied to us. When you see that,
and that's why
and you
I
still
mean,
continue
that's why,
to vote
that's why
for
I
yourself.
You guys, I want to make sure. I want to get Anna in here. I'm sorry, you guys.
Okay, well, you know, but I think this discussion that's going on between Sonny and Sara is reflective of of what we have been saying forever and ever.
Now, last week, when Sunny announced the sad news that her husband Manny's parents had both died of complications of COVID-19, she began to thank everyone on the panel who had done something for their family. She thanked Whoopi, although Whoopi wasn't there. She said Whoopi sent lots and lots of food. She thanked Joy. She thanked Anna. She thanked Megan because Megan and Ben sent bourbon. And, you know, Sunny and Megan, when they used to drink together, their favorite was the brown liquor, right? And also she said that Megan was great because she would distract her mind with all the pop culture news and things of that nature. Well, Sara was sitting there with this look on her face that was quite strange. And I think most viewers who were watching the show and who watched the entire show could tell that Sara kind of felt left out. And it did appear that, you know, well, did Sara do anything? I mean, because she never thanked Sara. Well, when they came back from a commercial break, which is where most people missed out, they didn't see this part. She then apologized, she being Sunny, and she said, I left out Sara. You know, Sara sent text messages and Sara, you know, Sara began to smile and things of that nature. So it was just an omission. It was not purposeful. Okay. And so after that, I began to see online people really spreading this rumor real fast and quick that these two girls, ladies rather, had a beef going. Well, I will tell you from my research, and my research spans beyond social media, and that's all I can say, I will tell you that there is no beef going between Sara and Sunny. They are very, very cordial to each other, and they respect each other. One of the things that Sunny has said about Sara is that Sara is very curious, and anytime Sara doesn't understand something, she turns to Sunny because that's her coworker. Sunny is one of those people, she is very, very helpful. Just like when Megan first came, most people didn't like Megan, and Sunny, as her coworker, tried to help her become likable by, you know, inviting her places and things of that nature. Now, that all wound up backfiring on Sunny. We talked about that because, see, Megan McCain is not the kind of person that you can befriend in the workplace. You can be cordial to her, but Megan McCain is a stab you in the back type of worker from everything I've seen in my research. Every job she's ever had, she just hasn't been friendly to people. The least little thing, she'll complain on you. So the bottom line is, no, these two women are not beefing. They're not fighting. They understand what their job is, and their job on this show is to give their true opinion. And one of the things I respect about Sunny and Sara, they are both honest in their opinion. That's why I was sharing with you guys the few times a few years ago when I tried to watch the talk, I couldn't because I could tell they were disingenuous in their opinions. And see, if you're going to get paid all this money to sit on these shows and give your opinion, you better do it. And see, not everyone can do that because it's very hard. Even what I'm doing here, what I do on my other channel, which is give my opinion about things, people think that's easy to do. It's not, because you have to make a decision. I'm going to say what I truly think and let the chips fall where they may. I respect Sara and Sunny because I believe, and I don't know this, of course, because I don't know them, but I believe that their opinions are genuine and that they're not coming on this show saying stuff and repeating talking points the way Megan does. I believe Joy's opinion is very pure. I believe that Anna's opinion is very pure. Now, when it comes to Whoopi, Whoopi doesn't do the research she's supposed to do. Whoopi is too busy doing other things. And so Whoopi's opinion very often is not very substantive, in my opinion. It's just kind of, you know, just like you what you and I are doing, you know. It's like we haven't been reading newspapers. One of the things I love about Anna said in a radio interview she gave in Miami a couple of years ago, is that how she prepares for her jobs as a political commentator, whether that's Telemundo or CNN or The View, is that she reads newspapers. She just keeps her eyes on, she just reads. You know, she says she doesn't watch a lot of television because a lot of television is opinion news. It's not just straight the fact. Remember, Sunny and Sara came to the show during the same season. They both came during season 20, which was 2016. Now, we know Sara left in 2018 because allegedly Megan ran her out and she went to another ABC show. But no. So guys, leave your thoughts about this below. And what do you guys think about, you know, the fact that, do you think that fans want to see drama? Do you think they want to see these ladies getting into it? I don't know. I know I can speak for myself as a fan. I don't. I actually love when they're all getting along. I love when they are all expressing their opinions honestly, and they don't care to let the chip. They are fine with letting the chips fall where they may. I appreciate that because I understand how much courage it takes. And I would just say that, you know what? If ever Sunny and Sara were to have a beef, I would have such a difficult time choosing sides. I probably would just not choose a side because I love Sunny and I love Sara too on the show. Okay, guys, thanks so much for tuning into the podcast. Leave your thoughts below.
Here we go again. Trying hard, but you wanna be my friend. Ain't no place to hide, ain't no one to run to. Here we go again. Call my bluff and you wanna be my friend. I'm the one you ride, I'm the one you ride to.